The Neyman-Rubin Causal Model, an essential tool for investors. Investing is a complex endeavor where understanding the cause and effect relationship between numerous variables is critical. Traditionally, investors have relied heavily on historical data and financial analysis to make informed decisions. However, these conventional methods often fall short in estimating causal relationships. A revolutionary approach to this problem lies in the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model, NRCM, a powerful statistical framework developed by Jerzy Neyman and Donald Rubin. The Neyman-Rubin Causal Model, also known as the Potential Outcomes Framework, has emerged as a go-to tool for investors seeking to quantify the causal impact of different investment strategies and decisions. NRCM provides a scientific methodology to understand causality, allowing investors to make more accurate predictions about the future and formulate strategies that will give them an edge. Understanding the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model. The Neyman-Rubin model is predicated on the concept of potential outcomes. In essence, it postulates that the effect of a treatment, cause, on an observation, effect, can be measured by comparing the actual outcome with the potential outcome that would have occurred had the treatment not been applied. In a perfect world, you would observe both outcomes simultaneously to determine the causal effect. However, in reality, we can only observe one outcome at a time, the outcome with the treatment or without it. This issue is called the fundamental problem of causal inference. For example, let's consider an investor considering the impact of a significant political event, such as a presidential election, on their stock portfolio. The investor wants to understand the cause and effect relationship between the political event, treatment, and the performance of their portfolio, outcome. Using NRCM, the investor will analyze the observed performance with the treatment and compare it against a theoretical scenario where the event did not occur, without the treatment. The difference in these scenarios will give the investor a good idea of the causal effect. Applying the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model in investing. The true strength of the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model in the investment world lies in its ability to evaluate the effectiveness of different investment strategies. Here's an example. Let's say an investor has heard about a new investment strategy that claims to beat the market. The investor decides to test it with a portion of their portfolio. They will be treating this portion with the new strategy while keeping the remaining part of the portfolio as it is. In this scenario, the new strategy is the treatment, the portfolio's performance is the outcome, and the fundamental problem of causal inference is how the portfolio would have performed if the new strategy hadn't been applied. The investor needs to create a control group that mirrors their own portfolio but without the application of the new strategy. This control group could be created by using historical data, similar portfolios, or sophisticated statistical methods like matching or instrumental variables. The difference in performance between the treated portfolio and the control group over time will help the investor understand the causal impact of the new strategy. The limitations of the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model. While the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model provides a robust framework for assessing causality, it is not without limitations. The biggest challenge is creating a valid control group, which is crucial for isolating the treatment's effect. This process can be challenging due to the confounding factors or variables that could affect both the treatment and outcome. In investing, many factors can impact a portfolio's performance, including market volatility, macroeconomic factors, and company-specific events. Therefore, creating a control group that accurately reflects the counterfactual scenario, the portfolio performance without the new strategy, can be quite difficult. Moreover, even if a well-matched control group is created, there's always a risk of hidden bias due to unobserved variables that are not accounted for in the analysis. These could include investor-specific characteristics such as risk tolerance, timing of investment decisions, and so on. In addition, the Neyman-Rubin model assumes that the treatment does not affect the control group, an assumption known as the stable unit treatment value assumption, SUTVA. This assumption may not always hold in financial markets. For instance, if an investor adopts a new strategy that involves buying large quantities of a particular stock, it may drive up the stock price, affecting other investors, and thus violating the SUTVA assumption. Despite these limitations, the Neyman-Rubin Causal Model offers a powerful way for investors to analyze the causal impact of their decisions. It presents a more scientific approach to investment analysis, going beyond the traditional correlation-based methods, to help investors quantify the causal effect of different investment strategies, thus aiding in more accurate decision-making. investors should not view the Neyman-Rubin model as a standalone tool but rather as part of their analytical toolbox. When used in conjunction with other financial models and economic theories, it can provide a more holistic understanding of investment outcomes and support better investment decisions. Moreover, advances in machine learning and econometrics are continually helping mitigate the Neyman-Rubin model's limitations, making it increasingly accessible and applicable to investors. So, while the road to perfect causal inference may still be under construction, the Neyman-Rubin causal model certainly puts investors on the right track. In a world where every bit of investment edge matters, understanding and applying sophisticated tools like the Neyman-Rubin causal model can be the key to navigating the complex financial landscape and achieving superior investment results.